Howdy all and welcome to Lax Lives. I think it's time to play a little Minecraft. Alright. So we are gonna work on... Oop, slid off the bed again. We're gonna work on... I'm not sure what today. Check it out, though. I finished the crane. Oh, I guess I didn't get the dirt out from behind it. I was using it on top of it. I think it looks pretty good. You can't really get into it from where it's at, but, yeah, I like the way it looks. It looks pretty good from out here. I did think I might add, I do still have some stairs here. I might add some stairs to it here. I don't know if it'll let me fit them in, though. I think... Okay, that's not what I wanted. Ah, you know what? It will let me fit them in. I'm gonna add these in here. Oh, I am shocked it let me put that front one in there. And... oh, shoof. That was close. That was close. I nearly fell to my death there. We think. Oh, I made it. Let me see how that does. Why? Okay, here. You know what? I'm not sure. I'm not sure about that. I might have to move them out a little bit more, but I do want some kind of flaps on them there a little bit, maybe. You know, if I ran and jumped, I'd have made that, and I didn't run and jump. So I worked on this this afternoon while I was actually on the phone. Nope. Wow. I really thought I could have made that. And, a little bit after that, too. Ooh, I'm gonna sneeze. Maybe not. Oh, yeah, no, I am. Or not. I don't know. It feels like I'm gonna sneeze, and then nothing. It's annoying. I bounced off the side. You know what? I'm gonna put a little platform out there so I can get inside and show you what I did on the inside, and then we'll hop down and take a look at it from the other side here. Look, we'll just do that. I got a little chair in here, a little lever. I don't know. So this is obviously a fairly large crane, and so it You know, I was going to put a second control spot on it, and I should have done that. I didn't do it, though. Oh, well. I'm not going to do it now. I'm calling this done. The other control should have been right here. A control booth to control the crane itself. But I think it turned out pretty good. Obviously, it's Minecraft, so things are a little boxier than I necessarily would prefer. But yeah, I've got the arm stretched out a little bit, and I've got the separate platform. You can see I've got supposed to be like a little thing that it rides on there, and put some red lights on the back. I put some glowstone on the front for lights. Put a little ladder here on the outside to climb up into the cab. Not that you can use it, but hey, it's there. And I put a hook on the end, or a, I don't know what that's called, a bucket. There we go. It's called a bucket. That's would that be? But yeah, I think it turned out pretty good. This here was, and that one over there were marking how far out the arm could reach. I wanted to make sure that it was going to be long enough to reach over here for when I put in, build the truck that it's going to be loading up with the materials. Which I thought we might work on that today, maybe a little bit. Hey, you know what? I've got some iron on me. I could get some iron in place. Some iron fencing in place to cover this up. Oh, that flower. Oh, got here, flower. I didn't want you when you jumped in my hands outside. I don't want you now. Okay. Whoops. Dang it. Now it's ruined. Ruined. That should grass up from down below. That should probably have a post in here as well. Yes, precisely. I wanted a torch because I'm gonna attach it to a torch. You goofy thing. Don't want anybody to accidentally drive off into the river, right? All right. Actually, this is going the other way, isn't it? There we go. Should probably have one on this side too. Wrap it around there a little bit. Like so. Yeah, today's been a long day, and I am very disappointed because it was supposed to be my day off, and it did not really work out to be a day off. I stayed up really, really late last night, and so I didn't get out of bed until really late, and all right, I am probably gonna use. Oh, dark oak, I think, for this, so that I can so that I can make it look a little more like tires. Okay, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 7. I already said that things were gonna be 5. And this is going to be a little bigger than a normal vehicle, so. Because it's another one of these big construction vehicles, right? Right, so we'll do that for the tires. And then I gotta go make some stairs. But, yeah, it's a. So I didn't get up till like noon, but I didn't go to bed till after 4. And you know, so when you say, "Oh, well, I didn't get up till noon," and then people roll their eyes at you, always irritates me because it's not like I slept longer than you did. It just means that I slept at a different time frame than you did. night, you guys can go. And so as soon as I check my email today, I got like 5 emails from work throwing a fit about... Oh, good. Yes. Yes, let's... Yeah. Because we finished up a session, a couple of sessions yesterday, and people are not happy about it. Who are people not happy about it? And they're like, well, you said... I'm like, no, that is not what I said. Stop trying to twist things and lay the blame on me. You know, I'm not sure that that's even working the way I want it to. I think we might just leave them like this. Although it would be better if I did them like this. But then I don't need... I can actually use, like, black wool for my big tires instead of the dark oak. Not that I have black wool, you understand, but I can go get some. I'll probably do that. I'm going to switch it to black oak. Or black oak. Wow. Black wool. But yeah, so I had to write a report. I'd already submitted some reports, but they were separate reports. And so they decided it would be easier if they had everything in one report. And I'm thinking, well, I already sent you the information. Can't you collate the information yourselves? Nope, sure can't. So I wound up having to go back through a year's worth of information and compile it. And then I get an email from one of my myriad of bosses complaining about, I'm going to have to talk to these people about what went down and... You're gonna, you know, I need to know what happened and why what they're saying is, you know, why they're saying you said one thing and now something else has happened. And, you know what, a lot happens in a month. Sorry. Basically what really has happened is this. They talked to me in the middle of May. And it is now not the middle of May. It is middle of June. And one of the people who was in the session I was teaching decided to stop attending the session. Oh, you cheap sheep. You gave me 5 wool. But decided to stop attending and has not been there for 3 straight weeks. So when they talked to me in June asking how things were going with this particular person, I said, well, as long as they complete everything, they should finish the program. And then after I said that, they disappeared for 3 weeks, showing up the final day of the session. Now look, those 2 sheep gave me 4, so what was wrong with you other 4? I should have had 8 off of you. And so, needless to say, not only did they not complete the session, but it impacts some other things that they were doing, which were dependent on them passing the final parts of the session, which they didn't do. Good for them. And somehow, that is obviously my fault. And, alright, I'm gonna... Use stones, I think, in the middle of this. For aw, really? I've only got three. Dang it. But yeah, so I was probably like 2 pages of information I had to. Well, it wasn't like a. Wasn't like information I'd given out all at one time before. So I had to basically type up a 2-page report about how things were being conducted. And, yeah. Annoying. Especially since it's supposed to be my day off. And then, like I said, after I figured out what I wanted to say in that, without, can't be angry in a report like that. Trying to figure out how to word it without. Unlike them, I don't like to lay the blame, in official things. And, maybe chatting like this, I lay the blame, but, in official things, I just try to state the facts. And, so when they say, well, you said. Yeah, but what I said was 4 weeks ago, and you said you had to have the information now, and I said this is where they're at now, and staying at this position requires them to fulfill all the rest of the assignments for the class, basically, and they didn't do it. I don't think it's that hard of a concept to grasp, especially, oh, I missed some wool. I apologize, sheep. I didn't realize that there was more wool back there from you. But especially given the fact that looking back over the reports that I have turned in, I have mentioned this was a problem twice this year. But apparently they don't read the reports that I send them until it's too late. Student. Sometimes they drive me crazy. All right. I still need more black wool, guys. And then after I get those two reports done, one of the reports, like I said, was a summary. Well, not even a summary, just a restating of all the data I had turned in. I had to turn in basically, what? Hold on, I'm trying to think what the word is. Basically, I turn in a report every three, well, every 10 weeks, maybe. And, so I had turned in my every 10 weeks report. And so each of those reports lists what's gone on in the session, and who's passing and who's not, and then at the bottom, each time I had included a paragraph about why I felt that they weren't, passing, which mostly consisted of students are failing to turn in all of the assigned work every time, and So, that was what happened this time, too. I mean, come on, you disappear for 3 weeks from something? I mean, that's just bizarre to me. I turn in a report every day to the people in charge of this on who showed up. Every day I turn in a report on that. And not once do they bat their eye in 3 weeks of someone not being there. Well, now they're not going to complete their program. Well, that's their problem. Ah, yes. Telephone. Gotta ring, because I'm recording. yesterday it didn't ring while I was recording, but man, it rang so much before I started recording yesterday. It was crazy. I hate the telephone sometimes. Once I finished all those reports, though, today, which took me a couple of hours to put together on my day off, immediately after that, you know what? I put my clay. You know, I was actually thinking I might do the dump truck, which I'm about to build, in acacia wood instead, so that I can take advantage of the different colors of, or the different things you can build with acacia wood, and maybe add a little more detail than just big orange blocks. So let's head out to the desert area. I'm gonna grab some acacia wood. But immediately after that, then I get a phone call from one of my friends who, you know, this is really loud, who I haven't talked to in ages, and the first words out of his mouth are, "You've been screening my calls?" I'm like, "What are you talking about? Well, I've called at least 3 times recently, and you don't answer the phone." I'm like, "Okay, I remember one phone call from you, and it was during dinner. I'm not answering phone calls during dinner, sorry." We also have call waiting, so chances are if he called and it didn't go to answering machine, not voicemail because I don't have a cell phone, precisely so people can't call me. And you know what? You know what the big, "I've called you 3 times and I need to talk to you." Oh man, it was life or death. He wanted to know when The Walking Dead was coming back on. Seriously. You play online video games. I should probably take back some saplings with me. Right, there we go. You play online video games. You have an email address that you don't use. You have a Facebook account, so obviously you are on the internet. Why are you calling me to find out when The Walking Dead comes back on? There's this thing called Google. I don't understand why people call me to have me Google things for them. It happens a lot. I know 10 is not going to be enough for my project here, but I can take these saplings back and work at my base instead of. Oh man. I did that. Well, I did part of that. Part of it was creepers. I remember one time, one of my friends called and he's like, "Hey, can you do me a favor?" I'm like, "Ugh, what?" And he's like, "I'm pretty sure I took the wrong road and I'm not sure where I'm at. Do you think you could Google it for me?" I'm like, "Can't you just pull over and use your smartphone?" "Yeah, but then I'd have to pull over and I don't know where I'm at and I don't know if this is a safe area to pull over in." I'm like, "Well, what's it look like?" He's like, "Well, it's a kind of a narrow 2-lane road and there's just woods all around me." I'm like, So then, even better is that a lot of the times when people call me and ask me about that, they then argue with my answers. And this was one of those cases because I told him what it said, and then he argued with me that what I read off the internet was not correct. And why do you even call me to ask me to Google it? Need some bone meal. I get very, very irritated by all that. Let's see, we should probably use some, maybe some stone. All right, I'll put some stone in here as the central point for the axles, the frame, I guess, if you will, for this thing. All right. And then, okay. I'm gonna make a crafting table out here so I can work on this. That's not a crafting table, buddy. That's a block of dirt. All right, I want some slabs. Why did you? I am on something that can be right-clicked. Why did you just put down a torch, you crazy thing? All right. I'm not sure what I want to do here. Okay, obviously it's gonna stick out past the wheels, so let's start with that. Okay, let's not start with that. Come on, there you go. At least one past the wheels. And I should probably do it up here. So I can put stuff in it, right? Oh, dude, we ran out already. I was just getting going. Yeah, I really hate when people ask me for advice or ask me how to do something, and then when I tell them, they argue with my answer. It is very, very irritating. It happens a lot. A lot. A lot. Okay. So now I think we gotta do this. And then we'll do this. Yes. Yep. I don't know why I just. No, that is what I wanted to do because I want to take that extra piece out of there. Yep, because then we can do the sides. Like this. Let me see what that looks like from the side. That's pretty good, pretty good. We're definitely gonna want to fill that in like that, though. Man, this is such a huge vehicle. Oh yeah, this down here. Okay. Now, what I was thinking of doing was. Oops. Well, first thing I have to grow some more trees, but what I was thinking of doing was, I'm gonna move this out with some spines, and then maybe run some, fences in there to look like supports on the sides. We'll see how that looks. I know what I have in my head, and I don't know if it's gonna work, but. So this is a fairly large dump truck for the stuff coming from here. Oh, you know what, though? We do have a height limit here on my door, don't we? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this can't be higher than 5. Really, 5? 'Cause these are 3. 4, 5. I've already reached the limit of the height I can have if I want this to be able to. You know what? We can't. We just can't do it in there. Wow. I need more room. Maybe what we'll do is I will. I'll knock a hole right here, and we'll do like a conveyor belt system in through the side here so the dump trucks can dump over here where I've got my tread. Oh, look, my treads are bump, bump. There we go. Finally greened in for me. And then we'll do like a pile of stone right here. I guess. We'll have to park the crane somewhere else, though. This is all gonna have to. Come on, we can't park the crane here. Maybe we'll park the crane back here. It'll be fine. Or we'll park the crane over. I don't know. I don't know. We'll figure it out. I like it. I really like it. I really like seeing the construction equipment. I really like the way the treads turned out. That looks really good over there. I like that a lot from here. It looks so good. And we'll get those couple things in there, and then on the other side here, we'll get semi with a flatbed on it, loaded up with stone, heading to town down the road here somewhere when we get the road in. Yeah, it's coming along good. I gotta get up there and fix that hole on the roof, though. And, oh man, I am really liking the way this is starting to fill in now that I got that nether tunnel done. And pretty soon we'll be out that way working on the city, which will be awesome. And then we can get into the theme of my new build soon. So, all right, click like you like, subscribe to be sure and catch the next one. I'll talk to you later.